What makes up a credit score? How can you improve your score?
There's five elements that make up your FICO score.
What are the five elements, Jer?
All right. Five elements. Payment history, number one.
So how you pay back your debts matters?
Yeah, kind of goes without saying, but important nonetheless. So that makes up 35%. That's the largest, it makes up the largest percentage of your FICO score.
Heavy thing. And I would like to point out that if you're late on a payment 90 days, that's worse than 60 days late, which is worse than 30.
Correct.
All right. So it kind of goes in how late you were and how many times you were late. So payment history is factor number one. Not surprising. What's number two?
Credit utilization.
Ah, yes.
And that means if you have a credit card account, that's the most common example.
Yep.
You have a credit card account, the credit utilization would be the amount of your balance owed in relation to the line limit,
the amount that you can
take out. The FICO experts say is 30% utilization is where you're going to what's going to result in the best possible score.
30% or lower.
30% or lower of utilization. So in other words, the $10,000 credit limit you mentioned, Brian, you'd want to make sure your balance owed stays at or below $3,000.
So if you had $6,000 on a $10,000 card where you're getting hurt by carrying that, what else could you do?
Well, I think we would all say best case scenario is always try to pay the balance down.
Okay.
But when that's not possible, you'd be better off applying for and opening up a second card and shifting 50% of that balance to that other card. The length of credit history and number of accounts is also a factor. That makes up for 15% of your score.
Okay.
And so this is a good time to remind people that when you have a credit card that may be a zero balance or you paid it off and you think, I'm never going to use this again, I think most people think, oh, I'm just going to close that account.
Yeah, close that
out. Do not do that.
Do not. What?
To have a credit card that you've had for 3, 4, 5, or even 10 or 15 years, even if you're not using it, is going to serve to help, again, elevate your score. Because
you have a long track record.
Long track record and access to more credit.
Okay.
And then new credit. And they're careful to say here, they don't encourage people to just go out and open up multiple just for no reason.
All right.
But to do so on a measured pace, occasionally, until you reach a mix where you have at least a handful of 3, 4. I think that's what we see most in most cases where
we have a good high credit score. People have,
and you don't have too thin of a credit file, meaning you only have one account reporting.
Right. Okay. So have a few credit cards open. What else does it like to see?
Final piece is credit mix, and again, this only makes up 10%.
Okay. So
credit mix meaning you have a mix of installment type debt, car loans, mortgage loans, student loans, and revolving debt, which is that credit card debt.